figures, growth, this is what we have done, this is where we are going. And perhaps it's the easiest topic to talk on because you can talk anything. Everything is HR. I mean, we are in the challenges, emerging HR challenges. If I say we can talk anything, I'm wondering for the teaching community, a challenge would be how to keep the students engrossed, because everybody gets every 5 minutes hooked on to this for something, all of us included. Social media, we find it difficult in the meetings. I'm sure that teaching people must be finding it extremely difficult to keep the students glued on to the thing. Of course, it's very useful also. You get a lot of information, a lot of updates, a lot of knowledge. But I mean, it's a big HR challenge, which I find is a new generation would find it difficult to deal with. Each generation feels that, oh, I mean, we are, our generation is feeling the one big challenge. My generation feels, my parents are not feeling that kind of this thing, but I'm sure my children would be feeling the other way around. Because these are the few challenges which are coming in HR sector. Coming back to energy, Mr. Shahi touched that energy has been a very, very protective sector of the government, maybe in the name of energy security, both petroleum, coal, power and all. Private participation has come much later. So when we go back little bit, we used to see, I worked in coal ministry and I realized when the private players were brought in coal mining as part of captive users, there was no manpower available. So they were dependent on the retired or the then present manpower of Coal India to get them, poach them, attract them and then work for this thing. Similarly, when the power sector was opened for private participation, same thing happened. Petroleum sector is still, I think, way behind. Very few private players have come in and still the HR issues would be there, the manpower issues would be there. So energy sector, I feel the challenges are much bigger because of the way this sector was under government control in India. But as I said, I mean, each generation, each level has its own challenges. So what are we looking at today? Oh, I'm looking at future, what kind of fossil fuel to non-fossil fuel, my target 40% capacity addition, we have made a commitment at Paris. 40% of the capacities would be from the non-fossil fuels as far as power generation is concerned. So now, I mean, the whole challenge is to shift from a coal-based power system to a non-coal-based gradually. It's very difficult. 80% of the power comes from the coal today, and whatever efforts we may make, it's going to be not easy to shelve it away just like that. But yes, capacity addition we can do 40%, but the contribution of that 40% would be, in energy terms, would be again very small. So we still continue to depend on fossil fuels as far as energy, substantive energy base is concerned. So, but when we have made commitments, we need to move to, in that direction. So what are the challenges? Are we looking at it? Are the man, is the manpower, the HR issues, are we able to handle it? Frankly, if I look at my PSUs internally, I happen to have worked with two CMDs sitting here, Neville Lignite and SJVN. Both were director HRs in their respective organizations, and I happen to have dealt with both in that capacities also. Is the organization's HR department, especially in public sector companies, are they thinking in those lines? I don't think so. So, I mean, the challenge within the public sector setting, energy sector is largely, is needs to outward looking. I think we need to remove the differentiation and say these are HR people. In a technical organization dominated by engineers, HR is not looked upon, I mean, at very this thing. I mean, they are HR people, they do some normal salary, leave, this, that and all. Perhaps we need to remove the differentiation in the thinking process within the management, and they are the top leadership of the government, of the management of that company has a big role to play. So that's why when I came here, I told Mr. Shahi that some focused attention on HR vis-a-vis whole energy sector is first time I am seeing it, and it's a good point to focus on these kind of issues at this level, because within each organization HR doesn't think like this. They have their own plans. NTPC has their own training institutes, their own systems on HR side, but still the larger macro view is not coming. Where are we looking at in future for this organization? We write words like succession planning. Do we do it that way? I don't think so. Because in public sector, again, the government rules, the DPE guidelines, and so many things are there that your succession planning is not exactly the way you would have ideally thought about it. So are the HR departments or the CMDs or the top management are thinking on those lines? Perhaps we need to bring, I'm very happy that most of the issues we are thinking, there are big HR guys of public sector companies in each panel over the next 2 days. But we need to look at beyond their HR role and see where the organization wants to go. What are the challenges and all? Challenges all of us understand, as is the electric vehicles is going to be a big future, this thing, it's going to come. Automobile sector is going to get into a big transition. Yes, we'll handle it. It's not difficult to deal with it. We are gradually moving in that direction. Government has already, the power ministry has brought in a charging infrastructure guidelines and made policy changes and all. So by 2030 and beyond, we definitely will have more electric vehicles coming. Now when these kind of changes take place in the whole scenario system, what kind of implications on HR is there? I mean, do we have the manpower to deal with it? How the whole system will start functioning? That kind of planning we need to make and see where any organization can it sort of mobilize itself and look at the future and do a planning in a manner that it can deal with that situation. As Singh was saying, NTPC is largely coal. They have small hydro, solar, wind. But you are very right, deep inside the thinking would still be a mainly a coal-based generating system in their minds, because that's what they have done all these years. So changing gradually into that, are we looking at that, okay, I mean in my future I will go like this and this is what the manpower I require. That kind of planning, Mr. Rajing Roy, Saptrishi Roy speaking in valedictory session, maybe people should ask him, are they thinking on those lines or something? So each organization should do that kind of HR planning. Go to private sector person, Mr. Sinha has appeared. I was blaming the PSUs, but you definitely have much wider experience. Will be, you are, I think the next session you are participating. What else we are looking at as HR issues? Energy efficiency, we are doing a lot of things. Government has reached each and every village. We have reached each and every household in electricity. New challenges are going to come. I mean, we at national level think, okay, from fossil fuel to non-fossil. Look at it from a village point of view. He's got electricity, he's wondering, this electricity line, if something goes wrong in my house, wiring, how it will, I will handle it, or I'll get it repaired. Perhaps we need to go down to that level also in energy sector, in planning HR manpower and all. We need to bring systems. Some of our PSUs are trying to do that, encourage skilling at the lowest levels, bringing manpower, skilling them, putting them in the field, because these are the opportunities which are going to come. When you reach electricity to large number of people in villages, these are the issues which are going to create trouble for them. So we plan a skilling kind of thing, but then all organizations who are into energy sector need to look at that, whether we have done our role in putting the things down. So I mean, I compliment the BIMTECH for this event. So Mr. Shahi was saying this, I mean, I happened to be in Raipur yesterday, and when he reminded me, I said, okay, I will try to come, and because I was supposed to be traveling today morning. So I came yesterday evening, and I thought I should be part to this innovative thing, I would say, on the HR issues as emerging challenges. And I'm sure we will come to know of the deliberations over the next 2 days, what are the issues which happen, where the government can come back and support some of the initiatives and push some of the things and all. Yeah. Thank you very much.